Welcome everybody. I'm Anna, and also tonight I'm here and I'm going to present Live With. This program, of course, is broadcasted by Adiga TV Show. Hope you're following us on Instagram, on Facebook, and also on YouTube. So put the like. Well, also tonight I have a big, big challenge. Are you ready for it? And I'm waiting for you in a few minutes. Hi everyone, I'm here with Ayman. Hi.
Hi, Anna.
How are you?
Thank you, I'm fine. Thanks for having me.
Thank you too to be here with us. And so tonight we have like a big challenge because you're a great artist.
We love challenges.
Of course. And so what do you think to introduce a little bit yourself about your art and...
To talk about myself, let's say. My name is Ayman Namroqa. Mm-hmm. I was born in Amman, 1977. I used to have this passion for art. I used to draw some patterns when I was a child, to draw some paintings. Then after I finished high school, I went to university and got my BA degree in business.
Okay,
it's not related here in Amman, in the University of Zaytuna. So actually it's not related at all to my passion. So after my graduation, I went to work in a business field, especially in telecoms. And I spent almost 12 years working there.
Wow.
It was fine and amazing and progress and it was good. But there is always something keep telling me there is passion that you forget all about it.
So while you were working, you also were drawing something and...
I let it go for years, by the way. Okay. I let it go, yeah. But let's say back 10 years ago, I started to push myself again to do some art work. After working hours.
Okay.
It was a little bit hard, you know.
I think so.
So I figured out to myself, I'm not that guy to spend like, I'm not that 8 to 5 person and go with the routine. I start to feel, no, it's not the thing that I want to be. So I always said I want to follow my passion. So it was like an argument and anxiety about doing art or having the business.
I think so.
Yeah. So I quit. I did this decision. And
then
I
you
quit.
Took the decision?
Yeah, yeah, okay. I did it. And after quitting, I had my first art exhibition. It was solo art exhibition back in 2014.
So you quit and then you start drawings.
Yeah.
And then of course, congrats, because I know that this in this time you have this your second solo exhibition here in Amman,
yes,
right?
Yes.
And how do you see the reaction of the people watching your paintings and your art?
It was actually the first solo art exhibition, Spaces Beyond Earth. It was a success to me because I saw how people interact with my art. They started asking me, how could you do this without studying art? I said, it's a passion. So after its success, I spent 3 years, now we are in 2017. Mm-hmm. This is my second solo. It was like a continuation to the first art exhibition.
Okay.
So people, when they came again, they saw a progress in my work, a different something so different and a progress. So they like it so much and I'm so happy to have my second
so
art exhibition.
Talking about your art, of course, what is abstract art for you and what does your art represent?
Okay, I always love seeing nature, mm-hmm. Looking at universe. I always love how elements in this universe interact together and create such a beauty. In my first art exhibition, Spaces Beyond Earth, I talked about lots of coral stones, Fayrouz stones, and how they spend billions of years in the universe to be created. My art is talking about nature, the elements of nature, and the beauty of nature. I'm trying to interpret this into the paintings or that I'm doing.
Okay, And so you also want to transmit energy, or do you have some sensations, some feelings that you want to?
I always into the positive energy.
Okay.
With art, I explore all my positive energy. It's so good when you're working with your art piece. You're spreading these vibes, and it's so good, so beautiful, so relieving.
Definitely. And so the name of the current exhibition is Abstract of
Presence.
Yes.
Yeah.
And what can the wanderer find in your art, and till when is this?
It was on the 12th of November. It stays till the 7th of December.
Okay.
It's in Zara Gallery here in Amman, in Grand Hyatt Amman.
Perfect.
Yeah. It's like at 26 pieces. It's like an abstract and mixed media on canvas with different sizes.
Okay, and I've noticed also that you are using lots of one color. What is the color? This color. What does it mean to you? And
of course, blue. Yeah.
Yeah.
You notice this
of
in my
course.
Paintings. Yeah. Blue and the shades of blue and the turquoise. This is my favorite color, actually.
Mm-hmm.
Also, people always notice you're using lots of blue. To me, blue is a very attractive color.
Okay.
It is so full of energy. You see, you feel so good when you're looking at a sea or at the sky. You feel so in relief. It is a so powerful color. I always love to use it and to put it in my paintings. So it gives me this energy, and I give it back to the painting. So, okay. And I feel the interacting with the people are looking at the painting. It is so beautiful, so relieving. I love it. It's full of energy, positive energy. It is so beautiful.
Definitely.
That's why it's in my
definitely.
Paintings.
And definitely it reminds me that the sea and the peaceful moments. And
It is yeah. So peaceful.
And how would you describe your relation with your artwork? I mean, from the time that you start painting until when
oh
you
my
finish.
God. It's like a journey. You okay. always start, and you know nothing. You don't know what are you going through. It's like a white canvas or a piece of wood, mm-hmm. and it's empty. And you start this journey with the piece. So you go like... doing layers of layers, spend sometimes. You leave it sometimes for months, and
okay.
then you go back and you leave it in the sun, let it rain on it, and let this interaction with the nature to go with the piece. So it's like a beautiful journey. But at the end, when I finally do this final touch or see it as this is the piece that I wanted. It goes like I don't know, maybe you can. I can describe it as my child's. Yeah, it's
okay.
something so beautiful. I enjoy the moment when I finish the piece. It is so beautiful.
And so you are somehow having an inspiration before start paintings, or is it something that you have in your mind? Is it something that grows up?
Yeah, it's actually it's with the experiences.
Okay.
And sometimes you start painting when you are down, when you are so down, and sometimes when you are so high and feeling so good. Sometimes you get a little bit inspiration of something you saw on the way to the studio. So it goes with the different moods. That's why you have this interaction with the piece. You see different okay. kind of pieces, different kind of elements with the piece. It goes with the mood, let's say.
And what type and what kind of material are you using in your painting?
I use I use sand. I use
okay.
pigments. I use acrylic. Back in times, I used to draw with oil, but it's not my thing because acrylic, it's dry faster, and it goes with the natural colors, the pigments and the sand. And this is what everybody tell me when they saw the paintings. They go into it's like so into nature. It's so these are the materials. I pick stones, I pick sands, I pick pigments to make it like really genuine piece.
Okay, and what are the stages, the steps that you are going into in order to have your creature, let's say?
The painting?
Yes.
Lots of stages. As I told you before, it's a journey.
Uh-huh.
And you start from scratch. It's nothing. It's just a white board.
Okay.
And you go explore. And with the back experiences, I noticed that whenever I tried more, and whenever I tried different techniques or different materials, I come up with different results.
Okay.
So it is so tentative when you.
And it's something that surprises.
Yeah,
you.
Yeah, it's always surprising. That's why it's good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's something always new
and
always
you, yeah, yes,
that
yes, yes.
you have to
absolutely,
explore.
Absolutely, absolutely.
And talking about the first exhibition, when it was and how was the feeling of having like the first solo exhibition?
Yeah, it was like, oh my God, terrific. It's the first time Ayman appears as an artist. Mm-hmm. They always see me as a guy who works in telecoms and in business. So before I quit, I spent around 2 years preparing for this thing. It was like 22 pieces and they were so huge. And they were on board and they used stones and materials. I was so afraid. I want to make this to happen because it's my first thing. So when I presented the pieces, it was back in 2014.
Okay.
In Zara Center. It was in Zara Center in 2014. I was a little bit scared, of course,
and
it's like anxiety and what's gonna happen. And it was,
so.
But when I interacted with people and they interacted with the pieces and they were saying beautiful things about my art, I felt so relieved. Because it was to me like a challenge. You were in a business field and you just quit it and you want to go on your own to be an artist. It is something not easy, but it was so good and fulfilling. I felt so good.
And how much does it take for you to prepare an exhibition? This
yeah.
is the first question. And also from my side, I would like to know, are you choosing the positions of the paintings, the sequence, where to put
yeah,
it,
yeah,
the
yeah.
place?
As I told you before, the first art exhibition, I spent 2 years preparing
yeah.
for it. For this one, Abstracts of Prisons, I spent, let's say, early 2016, a year, actually. Yeah,
okay.
I spent a year working on those 26 pieces. I sometimes try to contact galleries, you know, when you finish
okay.
your artwork, and there is now a background, and you know people, and they saw your art. So you start sending to people, and whenever people are interested, so they go for the shows.
Okay.
So they go, let's go with our gallery. So I went with Zara Gallery this time,
mm-hmm.
and they were so good and so supportive, by the way. We choose to put the paintings together.
Okay.
So it goes like argument, me and the people there.
Thanks.
Yeah, I remember when we were preparing this, I was with Daniel Roussan and Claude Zomot. They were representing Zara Gallery. And
mm-hmm.
we were, put this here. No, I want to put this here. And it was like, but it is so good. It's so beautiful. They are so supportive.
I think so. And are you painting at home or do you have a...
It's so hard to paint at home. If I used to have my own, let's say, den. This is my place. This is where I do my art.
Mm-hmm.
And you don't want to go there. It's so nasty, full of colors and pigments, and because you can't do the way the abstract art or the way I do it, the mixed media. You have to have your own place. Otherwise, nobody will visit you.
Of course, but like in my mind, I have like some pictures of artists, like famous artists, like at
in their galleries
and
in their studios.
In their studios.
Yeah.
In their
like
places, like using colors, using.
Yeah, this is what happened. Yeah.
So it is the same. And what about the challenges that you face in your life? I mean, I think that the first one, that it's not proper a challenge, but it's like to change completely your
pathway.
Yeah,
it was a challenge, actually. But I love challenges. I hate this routine life. If there is no challenges, you wouldn't do anything. So my first challenge, it was quitting business field. I spent lots of time there and following my passion. It was a challenge. The other challenge, it was how people are dealing with you, your
okay.
family, your friend, everybody. Are you crazy? Or this is how it goes. And the way people see art and artists, and they go like, no, you shouldn't be this, you should go into business back like normal people. So it was like challenges, but I get the support from my family, my friends. So, but actually, I went by my own, I want to do it, so
mm-hmm.
I did it. I don't care.
That's great. That's
yeah.
the good mood.
Yeah.
Okay, now it's time for the music, and we're going for the circassian music with Youssef Kouran and Zaid Haktus. And don't forget also to follow us. And please, don't go away. We're back in a few minutes. We're back, and please, we have the break, and in a few minutes we're back just for other few questions with Ayman that is here with me, so don't go away. We'll be right back. with Haiman. Hi again. And first of all, I want to thank Abunart and also to say good evening to Luna. And of course, I have other few questions because I'm so curious. Okay. So the first one is really simple, the two of them. Is your favorite artist?
Yeah.
And your favorite artwork?
My favorite artwork. Yeah, let's definitely start with my favorite artist. Of course, locally, of course, we can say Dr. Mohammed Qaytoqa. He's greatest here.
Mm-hmm.
And Farouk Lambaz. And I love Edward Lynch work, okay. And Salim Kiefer, Pablo Picasso. Those are the people that I admire and I love to see their artwork.
Have you ever been, like, for example, to Milan?
Because I always
amazing.
Follow him.
And your work really reminds me. When you were talking about Sands, and
reminds
me Kiefer, of course.
He's a great artist. He is a great artist.
He is.
Yeah. About my favorite piece, let's say Land of Fayrouz is my favorite piece with the Tranquil. Those both, they were presented in the previous Spaces Beyond Earth.
Okay.
With the piece, it was called Spaces Beyond Earth. Those three pieces, they were so, they meant something so beautiful for me. I love them so much.
So you get also your inspiration to this artist and to this.
Of course.
Okay, and do you have some tips, some advice to the youth that wants really to follow your pathway?
Let them quit their jobs.
To follow their passion. Course.
Yeah, of course, because you know, Anna, I always say it, God created us with each individual with a unique thing. So if you didn't work on this or live as unique as you are, how could you be just a person, like a normal person? So follow your passion, do what you love, you're gonna feel alive. Otherwise, it's gonna be like a boring life. So
exactly.
Do it, have the courage, and invest in yourself. Always keep learning, follow your passion, and you will do it. It is something so beautiful, and you will taste it, of course.
Of course, I really am with you, and thank you very much for everything.
Thank you, Anna, for having me, and thanks for the team, of course.
It was really a pleasure, and of course, I will be in to see your exhibition.
Sure, you should.
Yes, definitely. This weekend, I will be there, and thank you very much. Thank you to all of you.
Thank you.
Now we have other few minutes of music, and we will see in 15 days.
Thank you so much, Anna, for having me.
Thank you, too.